don't work and then depend on our work and depend on our deeds for results. No, we work and we depend on Allah for results. And that's a very, very important point. One of the things that happens a lot, and this is a pitfall that a lot of us activists fall into, is that we put our trust in our own activism. We put our trust in our own activism. And so what happens is when we don't see the exact results that we wanted, we lose hope. Inna lamudrakun. We have that attitude of we're going to be overtaken. But you see, if you put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, regardless of what you're seeing, you know that He's got your back. And that's what happened with Musa alayhi salam. He was told to strike the sea, so he's taking an action. But this is an important point. If I asked you right now, y'all are in, where am I now? Chicago. Yeah. If I tell you to go take a large staff or a large stick and hit, you know, Lake Michigan, it's not going to split. Why? It is not his action which caused the result. Why did he strike the sea? Because it was Allah who told him to. It was part of his worship. Every single thing that we are doing of our activism should be part of our worship. But we should never believe that our opening, that our salvation, that we're going to be saved because of our actions, because of our activism. We don't get saved because of our activism. We get saved by Allah. And this is a very, very important point of our tawheed, to understand it's only Allah who saves us. It's only Allah who provides the opening. He is Al-Fattah. He is Al-Fattah. I'm not Al-Fattah. You're not Al-Fattah. We're not, as organizations, Al-Fattah. We don't change our circumstances. Allah changes our circumstances. But here's a very important point about the formula for change. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيْرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيْرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Yes, Allah is the one who changes our circumstances. But Allah also says that indeed Allah does not change the condition or the circumstances of a people until they change what's inside themselves. At the same time, never despair. We have to at the same time have the attitude of kalla inna ma'a rabbi sayahdin. Indeed my Lord is with me and he will guide me through. This is extremely essential. And I will tell you this. If you are focused too much on the problem, you will have the reaction of Bani Israel. Because if all we talk about is the problem, if all we think about is the problem, if all we post about is the problem, if all we discuss is the problem, then what happens is, and this is a psychological reality, whatever you focus on grows. Whatever you focus on grows. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to focus on dhikr. That the more that we focus on the remembrance of Allah, the bigger the importance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in our lives. But if we're focused on everything that's going wrong, if our focus is on everyone who's saying this about us, and they're going to do this to us, and then this, and that's it. And that's my focal point. I promise you, we will fall into despair. And the reason for that is that the problem will actually grow because it becomes our focal point. And this is a dangerous thing that we fall into. Our focal point needs to be Inna ma'a rabbi sayahdeen. This is a very different focal point. The focal point of Musa alayhi salam. Indeed, my Lord is with me and He will guide me through. Yes, I do my part. But while I'm doing my part, my heart is looking at Allah. My heart isn't looking at the problem. My heart isn't focused on what Trump is saying or what Trump isn't saying or what he's going to do or what he's not going to do. Yes, I do my part because it's part of my worship. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is my focus. And when Allah is your focus, then you don't fall into despair because you know that Allah's got you.